I am the salvation of the people, says the Lord. Should they cry to me in any distress, I will hear them, and I will be their Lord forever. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with all of you.
And with your spirit.
We seek the good, the beautiful, and the truth. So God gives us what we desire, his Son's true presence in this Eucharist. We call to mind our sins, the times that we have failed to see his Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, and to serve him in the prayers of the Holy Mass. Lord Jesus, you have given us the forgiveness of our sins. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you have given us the consolation of the truth. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are the good shepherd, leading us into everlasting life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who founded all the commands of your sacred law upon love of you and of our neighbor, grant that by keeping your precepts, we may merit to attain eternal life. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Ecclesiastes. Vanity, vanity, says Qoheleth, vanity of vanities. All things are vanity. What profit has man from all the labor which he toils at under the sun? One generation passes and another comes, but the world forever stays. The sun rises and the sun goes down. Then it presses on to the place where it rises. Blowing now toward the south, then toward the north, the wind turns again and again, resuming its rounds. All rivers go to the sea, yet never does the sea become full. To the place where they go, the rivers keep on going. All speech is labored. There's nothing one can say. The eye is not satisfied with seeing, nor is the ear satisfied with hearing. What has been, that will be. What has been done, that will be done. Nothing is new under the sun. Even the thing of which we say, this sea is a new thing, has already existed in the ages that preceded us. There is no remembrance of the men of old, nor of those to come will there be any remembrance among those who come after them. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
In every age, O Lord, you have been our refuge.
In every age, O Lord,
you have been our refuge. You turn man back to dust, saying, return, O children of men, for 1,000 years in your sight are as yesterday, now that it is past, or as a watch of the night.
In every age, O Lord, you have been a refuge.
You make an end of them in their sleep. The next morning they are like the changing grass, which at dawn springs up anew, but by evening wilts and fades.
In every age, O Lord, you have been a refuge.
Teach us to number our days aright, that we may gain wisdom of heart. Return, O Lord, how long? Have pity on your servants.
In every age, O Lord, you have been our refuge.
Fill us at daybreak with your kindness, that we may shout for joy and gladness all our days. Prosper the work of our hands for us. Prosper the work of our hands.
In every age, O Lord, you have been our refuge.
Okay. Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
I am the way and the truth and the life, says the Lord. No one comes to the Father except through me.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Herod the Tetrarch heard about all that was happening, and he was greatly perplexed because some were saying, John has been raised from the dead. Others were saying Elijah has appeared. Still others, one of the ancient prophets has arisen. But Herod said, John I beheaded. Who then is this about whom I hear such things? And he kept trying to see him. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
And Herod kept trying to see Jesus. Remember the scriptures, they tell us that Herod liked to listen to John the Baptist. But Herod was very much perplexed by all that John said. Herod, like all of us, he's drawn to the truth. He's drawn to the beautiful. We human beings, we naturally gravitate toward these things. We gravitate toward the good, the true, and the beautiful. Herod wants to know the truth, but when he hears the truth spoken, he cannot understand it, because the truth is contrary to what he wants it to be. Remember, John the Baptist told Herod, you cannot have your brother's wife. But Herod wanted Herodias. She was so beautiful. When our wants and desires are contrary to the truth, then we work hard to bend or to change the truth to be what we want the truth to be. The trouble is, the truth is unchangeable. Despite all of our efforts, we cannot deface the truth. And so when the scriptures tell us that Herod kept trying to see Jesus, we could substitute in there that Herod kept trying to see the good, that Herod kept trying to see the truth, that Herod kept trying to see the most beautiful thing that there is. Herod kept trying to see God, but he failed, because when Herod listened, he did not hear. And when Herod looked, he did not see. Jesus said to his disciples, you will look for me, but you will not find me. But trust in me, said the Lord. Believe that I never leave your side, that I'm with you always. Though you cannot see me, I am with you to the ends of the earth. That's what Jesus said. You and I will see the good. We will see the truth. We will see the most beautiful thing our eyes could ever see in the Mass today. We will see Jesus Christ truly present in the Eucharist. But our eyes will be deceived. They will see only bread. But we trust God. We have faith that Jesus is truly before us, body and blood, soul and divinity, in the Eucharist. Herod kept trying to see Jesus, but he never saw him. Never saw Jesus as God. But you will see God today when you look at the Eucharist. Call to our Lord with all of our prayers and petitions. We thank Jesus for giving us the consolation of the truth, his true presence dwelling amongst us in the sacrament of the Eucharist. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We are grateful to the beauty that God has given to each one of us, and we only ask that the Almighty would one day give us a glorified body from which to praise him forever. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for the sick, the lonely, the depressed, those who suffer from addictions. Pray for Neil Vossen, Velma Quest, Marilyn Bunnell, Carol Bunnell, all who have eye ailments, that through the intercession of the saints and angels, our plea for their return to good health would be brought before the Father's throne in heaven, and would grant that good health through his Son, Jesus. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray that our beloved dead would have the clear vision of the truth as they behold God forever in heaven. We pray especially for James McCulley at this Mass. Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord,
and let perpetual light shine upon him.
May he rest in peace.
Amen.
May James, the soul, and all the souls of the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace.
Amen.
We pray for that special, beautiful baby that we spiritually adopted, as we call out, Jesus, Mary, and Joseph, I love you very much. I beg you to spare the life of James, the unborn baby that I have spiritually adopted, who is in danger of abortion.
Amen.
We pray that when we sin, that Our Lady would help us to be contrite, to ask God's forgiveness and confession, that we may truly see the Virgin Mary's Son whenever we behold the Eucharist. So we pray. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Heavenly Father, we ask you to hear and to answer all of these prayers and to grant them through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God, of all creation, for through your goodness we have received what we offer you, the fruit of the earth, the work of your hands, it will become for us bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer. Fruit of the vine and work of your hands, it will become our spiritual bread.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, my brothers and sisters in Christ, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, our good with all his holy church.
Receive with faith, O Lord, we pray, the offerings of your people, so that what they profess with devotion and faith may be theirs through these heavenly instruments, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Father most holy, through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ. Your Word, through whom you made all things, whom you sent as our Savior and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin. Fulfilling your will and gaining for you all holy people, he stretched out his hands as he endured his passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so with the angels and all the saints, we declare your glory, as with one voice we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You just be seated with the Eucharistic prayer.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the Father of all holiness. Made holy, therefore, these gifts you bring. Thank you, God, for the light and thought, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed, and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all, and eat it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and the eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory."
Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection, you have set us free. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life, the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis and Pope, the main commission, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters, who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, and Joseph, her spouse, the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, my Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope of the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on your sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord,
I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
I am the good shepherd, says the Lord. I know my sheep, and mine know me. Now we'll prepare spiritual humor.
My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the Blessed Sacrament.
I love you all the things, and I desire you in my soul.
Since other people dear to me cannot now receive you sacramentally, I ask you to come and please spiritually into their hearts, as though you are already in our hearts. Help us to embrace you and unite ourselves wholly to you. Permit not that we should ever be separated from you. Amen.
And I'll bring Holy Communion to you at your spot, so I'll just wait for your arm and I'll bring them to your seat. Oh, a prayer of thanksgiving. My Jesus, I love and adore you. You have come to me.
I am one with you.
I want you to remain with me forever,
in this life and in the next.
Thank you for allowing me to share your life and my life.
May I become one with you through this sacred food.
Let me never take you for granted, but always pray for those whose lives are dark with sin, ignorance, and selfishness.
Let me remember the words of St. Paul,
that there with the grace of God go I.
Each day I can become one like you, O Lord,
and each day I can pray for those who have never heard of your presence in the Eucharist or who have heard it and rejected it.
Let us pray. Graciously raise up, O Lord, those you have renewed with this sacrament, that we may come to possess your redemption, both in mystery and in the manner of our life, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Shine through us, Lord. Be so in us that every soul we would come in contact with this day may feel your presence in our soul. We'll pray our chaplet of the Infant Jesus of Prague. I'll give you a little picture of the Holy Heart so that we can assign six members of our family that we'll pray for, and three members of our friends, and then three members of our Christian community that we'll pray for. So invoke one of each of the Apostles, the Holy Apostles, to pray a Hail Mary with us for their salvation, the remission of all their sins. We pray especially in this holy hour for all who are sick, all who are in the hospital suffering, all who have surgeries, and for all who have chronic problems, especially addictions. We pray for our beloved dead. Doing penance for them, they would enter into glory sooner rather than later. We pray for our church as we undergo these Eucharistic years. Greater understanding of God's presence in the sacrament. Pray always for your special private intentions. Sacred Heart of the Infant Jesus of Prague, bless and protect our families. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Immaculate Heart of Mary, we say this prayer for our own mother. We thank you for welcoming them into heaven. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
St. Joseph, we pray this prayer for our dead. We thank you for welcoming them to your Son's kingdom. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
St. Bartholomew, we ask you to pray for one of our family members. The Word became flesh and dwelt among us. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
St. James the Lesser, we thank you for praying for one of our family members. The Word became flesh and dwelt among us. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
St. Andrew, we thank you for praying for one of our family members. The Word became flesh and dwelt among us. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
St. Peter, we thank you for praying for one of our family members. The Word became flesh
and dwelt among us.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
St. Paul, we thank you for praying for one of our family members. The Word became flesh
and dwelt among us.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
St. John, we thank you for praying for one of our family members. The Word became flesh. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
St. James the Greater, we thank you for praying for one of our best friends. The Word became flesh. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
St. Thomas, we thank you for praying for one of our best friends. The Word became flesh
and dwelt among us.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
St. Philip, we thank you for praying for one of our best friends. The Word became flesh
and dwelt among us.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
St. Matthew, we thank you for praying for one of our fellow parishioners here at Our Lady Perpetual Church in Sublette. The Word became flesh
and dwelt among us.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
St. Jude, we thank you for praying for one of our fellow parishioners here at Our Lady Perpetual Health Church in Sublette. The Word became flesh
and dwelt among us.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
St. Simon the Zealot, we thank you for praying for one of our fellow parishioners here at Our Lady Perpetual Church in Sublette. The Word became flesh
and dwelt among us.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end.
Lord, we thank you for sending your 12 apostles into the world, your best friends. May they be our best friends as well. May these 12 holy apostles, these holy men of God, Pray for us, our family members, our church community members, and our best friends. We would make reparations for their sins here on earth and spend as little time in purgatory as possible, accepting the invitation of the wedding feast that you gave them at their baptisms. And Lord, when your Father comes in to inspect us at your wedding feast, may find us all clothed in our wedding garments. We ask this to the Sacred Heart of the Infant Jesus of Prague. May always have mercy on our souls.